What's up, guys? Nepenthes here, and welcome back to some more Football Manager. We have got some good news and some bad news. The good news is we're back on Football Manager. We're back here. We've changed tactics. I've gone for a 4-1-2-1-2. I've had a massive play around. I've been testing some other stuff on my other game, and I'm hoping this is going to work. Obviously, they're not as familiar with it as the other tactic, but look at that. The familiarity is competent, and it's almost halfway. And then with the 4-2-3-1 that I've been playing, it's still only competent and just about halfway. So that's the good news. The bad news is my two of my three games today, two of my PPR games are against Liverpool and Arsenal. So I highly expect two more BPL losses to come in. And why is Shane Long gone there? I did not. All right, it's because I need to go back to this. It's going to be bad. So that's the bad news. So I've been reading a lot of the comments, and a lot of people are having problems just like me. And a lot of people just think that I'm just a really, really bad football manager, which is probably likely. I'd say me being bad at the game is a lot closer to what's really true than the game just screwing me. That being said, I do remember that we have had a few games where we've had good chances and not managed to come on top. But here we go. We've got Wanyama in the game, guys. Wanyama to Davis loses out to Fabio Borini, who plays into Philippe Coutinho, who loses out to Nathaniel Clyne. I have got a big man, little man up front. So I've got, hopefully, I'm using the target man in Pele. And he is the kind of like the big tall. Wait, is that a penalty? Holy shit, that, what? Oh my God, it started already, guys. We're only 15 minutes into the game and it's already started. Borini steps up, he scores. It's 1-0 Liverpool, and that's a bad start to the day. But yeah, so I've gone for like the target man and the complete, or like the poacher, you know, the fast forward, the big man, little man kind of style, I guess. What have we got here? Where's the match stats? Why aren't you showing me the match stats? Match stats, there we go. Well, we haven't even had a shot yet. We haven't even had a shot. Liverpool are dominating us. And this is why I don't think I'm going to be a good football manager, because look at this. I can't do anything. We're going to concede from another corner. No, we're not. Maybe we are. Borini has the ball again. Plays it out wide to Philippe Coutinho, who plays it into Lucas Leiva, of all people, to smash it from 20 yards and put it in the back of the net. I expect to be fired by the end of this video, because I can largely expect to lose here to Liverpool. I might get a win against Reading, and then I can pretty much damn well expect to lose to Arsenal away from home. This is not good. This is not good. But look at this Liverpool team. They have absolutely battered us. 19 shots. Here's Jose Enrique. He has a shot. It goes wide. That being said, they've had 10 long shots. So that's not too bad. It's just that we're not creating enough chances. I guess that's a problem within my management yet again. I'm taking on board a lot of what you guys are saying. You know, I read the chat a lot. I try and adapt a lot, but obviously changing things too much is counterproductive, because the team, oh my God, what is that? The team need, they need like specific instructions that they can get used to, you know? And that they're just not getting that right now, because I've been tinkering. Oh my God, what a save from Boric. This is another disappointing performance, I guess. I have got some, you know, some individual instructions on again. We didn't do good in this game, that's for sure. But we haven't done too bad. You know, we only lose 2-0, which compared to the games where we played against Chelsea and Manchester United, where we leaked goals, this isn't too bad. That being said, Liverpool have had 26 shots, but 12 of those from long range. But that means 14 shots from close range, which is terrible. And that was yet another bad performance, and we still find ourselves in trouble in the Premiership in 18th place, with just 4 points from 9 games, and both Sunderland and Burnley can overtake us today if results go their way. So, with that in mind, we are in trouble. And I genuinely wouldn't be surprised if I got sacked by the end of this video. Because I'm playing, like, we're supposed to be, like, a mid-table, top of the table, you know, top half of the table kind of push kind of team. Fortunately, I'm still 18th, which means 20th. Yeah, Sunderland lost, and where's 19th? And Burnley lost, which is good. Leicester lost, West Ham won, Stoke lost. Like, the bottom teams losing is good for me because it means it'd be easy for me to get up the table if we manage to get back on a win streak. But like I say, I do read the comments and I do take on board what you're saying to me. So, again, sometimes it's like I can't change too much because I don't want to I don't want to fuck up, basically. I don't want to keep changing and changing and changing and not have them get used to everything. In terms of training, I don't take care of the training. The assistant manager takes care of the training. Hopefully, he should be good enough. Right, we need a winger. Let's put Mayuka out on the wing there. Wow, he is a bad winger. That is not good. I thought he would have been better because it's almost one of his natural positions, I guess. The rest of the team is okay in terms of fitness. I mean, Tadic is okay in terms of fitness as well. Lens is injured. We're just struggling to score goals is the problem. Let me put this guy to attack. So just to give us another, let me put him to attack as well. I just want a bit more out of them, you know. I just want a little bit more out of the midfielders. Because we did, I don't want to say we did okay defensively against Liverpool because they had so many shots. But with that in mind, we did okay. Like, we didn't concede too many goals, which is nice. Right, I want to give them I expect nothing but a win from this match, which is true. I expect nothing but a win from against Reading. And since we are against Reading, let's just go on standard instead of counter, because we are the better team here. We should be winning a game like this. Federici there picks up the loose ball, and let's see how this game goes. So 5 minutes in, no highlights as yet. But look, as you can see by the stats, Southampton having all the shots. And we're going to have a free kick here. Ward-Prowse out to Klein. Klein into Shane Long. He's offside. God damn it. At least we're pressing forwards. Hey, guys. We've had four shots. Four long shots. How do we have four long shots? We need to start working the ball a bit more. And we've got a black man here. Into Edwards. Edwards loses out. Wanyama doing a great job there. Oh, look at that. Tekkers. Unbelievable Tekkers from Wanyama. Alderweireld into Bertrand. Into Pelle. Tadic there. Plays a long ball up to Shane Long. Oh, the Cooper has just got that. Oh, my God. It's just one long ball. Blackman has the ball. And we're just going to get... Oh, my God. Boric with a good save. This is what's frustrating. Like, when I play counter-attacking football, I don't do that. Like, these guys just bang, 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 and, like, they're in on goal. Me, I the team daddles on the ball. No matter if I play, you know, attacking, if I play aggressive, if I play direct. Oh, my God, you got to be joking. Bertrand tries to clear it. It smashes into Wanyama and goes into the back of the net. And now we're going to concede from another corner. Maybe we're not. Maybe we're going to score from a corner here. Shane Long, he's got the ball. He's got some space and some pace. He's got men up. Oh, he gets tackled. It falls into Wanyama. Is that Davis? Oh, my God. If that's not offside, that is a stunning goal. And that is a stunning goal. And Graziano Pelle scores his first ever goal for Southampton about 12 games in. What the fuck? That's terrible. I want to... If you can hear those birds, I don't understand where they're coming from. The fucking birds just need to piss off. That's good for us. We are back in the game, but we're not dominating the game by any stretch of the imagination. Possession is even, chances are even. We got a corner for ourselves there. Ward-Prowse puts that in. Wanyama is going to be there to pick up the loose ball. We've got men over on the left. If he can switch it, oh, he plays a long ball up and just loses possession again. Wanyama is not doing a good job for us, and they've got. Look at this break. Edwards here is going to whop that ball in. Obita at the far post, and that's. All that came from Wanyama gifting them the ball. Come on, bro. Why would you try like a 45-yard pass when there's a simple pass on? I just don't understand. And in losing to Reading will be the worst thing ever. But the corner comes in. That was just a chance gone. Federici here with a goal kick. Plays that long. Alderweireld is there. Shane Long comes inside. Surely fouled there. Schneidlin plays it to Pelle. Pelle's got Tadic down the left-hand side. Tadic with a little bit of skill there. Plays it out to Bertrand. Bertrand comes inside to Davis. Davis back into Pelle. Pelle to Shane Long. He looked offside again. He was not. And there it is. 2-2 is the score. Shane Long scores the goal. Bringing on Schneiderlin changed things instantly. That, you know, he was instrumental to that attack right there. I'm just hoping we can go on and actually nick the game now and give ourselves a win and give ourselves a confidence boost, because my God, do we need it. My God, do we need it. But we're into the 90th minute now and it's not looking likely. It's the end of 90 minutes. Our players are knackered. We're going to have to bring on Majuka comes on. Tadic, let's bring off Tadic for the young lad that's been out on loan this season. See if he can do anything. And apologies for my phone going off there. I'm going to have to grab that because if it's an important message, I am going to have to end the video short today. Let's have a look. But we got, please don't let them score. Is that a penalty? Thank God for that. It's not a penalty. Come on, boys. We're in the 106th minute. We're in extra time. I want to see us go and win this game. Look at Reading's stats, man. 17 shots to our 10. I just don't get how we can do any better than this. We're playing against Reading. We should be smashing a team like Reading. This should be like 3-4, 5-0 win for us. No disrespect to Reading fans, but we should definitely be doing a lot better than what we're doing here. We got a corner though. Oh shit! Alderweireld deep into injury time in extra time. 120th minute, 40 seconds on the clock, and Alderweireld bangs it in the back of the net from the corner. And my God, that was good. And that is full time right there, guys. That is game over. And we managed to pick up the win. And I'm going to give them a very nice victory. Well done. Everyone looks a bit haps. And they've got to be, really. Because, wow. Like, in the most ridiculous circumstances, we win the game deep into injury time. However, we have Arsenal next. And that's... Wait, Southampton in 2-goal comeback. We were never 2-0 down. Oh, we were 1-0 and 2-1 down, I guess. Pelle ends goal drought. Fuck yeah, he does. The good news is we a lot of good stuff happened that game. We turned the game around. Pelle scored. We won the game. We're through into the next round of the cup. Everything's just going a bit better for us right now. Everything is just going a little bit better. And then we come up against Arsenal. So, right, here we go with the quarterfinal draw. Right, I'll take Hull. Not interested in that. I don't want Man United. Okay, they got Brighton. So, I'll take Burnley or Aston Villa. I just don't want Chelsea. Just don't give me Chelsea. Yes, we get Aston Villa, guys, in the quarterfinal of the Capital One Cup. It's crazy how we've made it this far in the Capital One Cup, but we can't get a win in the BPL. Like... It's just nuts. Hopefully, though, the tides turn right now. I'm definitely going to be playing counter-attacking football tactics. So I want counter. I'm going to turn these instructions off again. I wanted to like play a bit wider, just to like flip the ball into Pelle and Long. You know, start crossing the ball and stuff. But it just doesn't. No matter what I do with those. Team instructions, it doesn't seem to do anything. So, with that in mind, we're going to go counter-attacking against Arsenal, who are in 7th place. Liverpool beat Manchester City. The top of the table is just a mess. Like, nobody's really, like, pulling away. But here we go against Arsenal. Can we hook it up? Last game of the episode, just not losing is key here. Not losing is what I'm looking for. Just don't get demolished. Don't lose. It's a bittersweet for me though, because I'm playing against Arsenal. Don't really care if they win the game. You know, they are dominating possession and chances. Look at this. It would not surprise me if we did get battered here. They've had 8 shots already after just 26 minutes. They've had 60% possession and are just all over us. Even though I'm playing counter-attacking football, Ozil there whips that in. Fonte clears it. Florenzi here plays it into Koscielny. Oh my God. See, this is... Like, I don't know how to manage that. Like, how can I manage? Like, what can I do different that stops Laurent Koscielny banging one in from 20 yards? Like, what can I honestly do? I don't know what I could do with that. Like, it's not my fault Koscielny can smash him in from 20 yards. It's not my fault the keeper decides to just dive under the ball. I just don't know what I can do to stop that. And again, this is another game where, although we're not losing by too many goals... we're definitely not in the game. You know, we're being battered. Although we're going to have a chance here. Oh no, we're not. This is going to be a counter attack because this game likes to fuck with you. It likes to show you a highlight when you've got possession of the ball, and you're going to sit there and you're going to think, "Yep, I've got a good chance here." And then what actually happens is you concede and you're 2-0 down, and Aaron Ramsey scores for Arsenal. And once again, I am at a loss as to what to do. New formation didn't change a thing. We struggled against Reading. Although we won, we struggled against Reading. New formation didn't. Oh, it doesn't help that the two teams we've come up against today have been Liverpool and Arsenal in the Premier League. We need, like, what I would say an easy game, even though we're probably the easiest team in the league right now because we've only won on the first day of the season. Look at that. That's a second goal that we've conceded from outside the box. I don't know what to do to stop that. I literally just have no idea what to do. I am at a massive loss, and like I say again, it would not... Why is Klein just letting Ox get that? Why won't he close him down? Like, this is just simple football shit. This isn't stuff that I should have to tell them. He should just know to close him down there instead of just letting him run. That's crazy. That's absolutely crazy. And now we are taking a battering, and we've only had two shots, and they were both in the first half. Davis clears that long. Mertesacker back to Ospina. Man, like... I just don't know if I'm going to get another chance as Southampton manager, because this board, like, if I was the board, I would fire me because I've been terrible. I've been literally terrible. I can't think of a worse. I could have probably picked the worst BPL team in the division, which I don't know who it is. I don't know who's expected to finish 20th, and done a better job than I have done with this Southampton team, who have really good players, and it's just me playing, managing really bad. And we're 4-0 down now. Giroud here has the ball, plays it into Welbeck. Look at that. He's just casually strolling on by. Two men marking him. Two men marking him. And they didn't even get close to him. Just... Oh, wow. This is going to be a goal. Oh, shit. Wow. Giroud has missed it. I can't wait for this game to be over, honestly. There's no point in me... Like, I could have made some changes. I could have made some subs. I could have made some tactical changes in the game. But what's the point? When you're 4-0 down... Like, there's just no point. Look at the stats. 29 shots they've had to 3 that we've had. And that's not on. That's not good enough. This Southampton team are just letting me down. And ultimately, it is my fault. Like, Football Manager is a game of ones and zeros. It's a game based around stats and formulas. And if you can figure out how to best create the best formula, you'll win the games majority of the time. It's obviously a little bit of chance, a little bit of luck, but ultimately it's a stats game. It's a ones and zeros game, and I'm just not picking the right stuff. Can't even score a simple chance like that. The crazy thing is 31 shots that Arsenal have had, no clear-cut chances. No clear-cut chances in 31 shots. They just don't care anymore. They're getting upset and now. Like, everyone just doesn't give a fuck. And I am still the Southampton manager, which is absolutely crazy. I should be performing slightly better in my role as manager. Well, holy shit. If you only think I should be performing slightly better, I've got a great chance here. I need Schneidlin back in the team because he's not doing me any good. And Boric as well needs to piss off because he concedes the dumbest goals. But anyway, guys, this is going to be the end of the video. Hopefully you enjoyed this. If you did, be sure to leave a like, rating, comment, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. But for now, guys, see that? I'm getting tired of this shit. I'm getting tired of losing. Look at this. Look at this. We won that first game against West Ham 4-1. And I was like, yeah, should be beating a team like West Brom. We should have won that game against Spurs. We should have been beating a team like Swansea. Got dicked by Chelsea. Should have probably beat a team like Leicester. Dicked by Man United. Newcastle, they got a decent team. Liverpool, they got a decent team. Arsenal, they got a decent team. Now, we've got Villa, QPR, Hull, Stoke, Burnley, Palace. I should be picking up 4 or 5 wins out of those 6 games. Like, realistically, should be getting 4 or 5 wins out of those 6 games. But I probably can't see it happening. So we've got Chelsea at top of the table. Newcastle in second place there. Everton, look at that. Look, 18, 18, 18, 16, 16. Even all the way down to like Villa here in 12th. They're only 6 points away from third place. That's crazy. And there's us on 4 points. Holy shit, we're in trouble. We're 4 points away from Leicester. A win wouldn't even be good enough to get us out of the relegation zone. But anyway, guys, this is the end of the video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. I'm out. Peace.